Welcome to the project demonstration of solar tracking system by using Arduino and LDR. So here we are going to tracking the sun position based on the LDR input to the Arduino Uno. So when sun travels, so the LDRs will get the intensity and that will be converted into the voltage. So that voltage continuously monitored by your Arduino Uno from A0, A1 pins. So based on that intensity, nothing but in terms of voltage, our microcontroller will take a decision to rotate the servo motor in order to make the same voltage from these two LDRs. So if the sun is moving towards the, consider this one is the east and this one is the west. So when he is moving towards the west side, then this particular LDR will get the more intensity than this LDR. So that it will get the more voltage from this one. So our controller will rotate the a servo motor in clockwise rotation slowly till it will get the same voltage, nearby same voltage from these two LDR sensors. So we have interfaced these two LDRs from this driver board with 10k pull up resistors to the A0 A1 pins, and servo motor is connected at the 9th pin of our Uno board, and the whole system getting power supply from this 3.7 volts 18,000 mAh battery we are using here. Sorry, 1800 mAh battery we are using, and here the servo motor voltage is 3.3 volts operating voltage, same from this one, and this is a rechargeable battery. So we have connected the solar panel outputs directly to this battery through the diode. So why? Because if there is no sunlight available on the surface of this solar panel, then it won't get any voltage outputs. So if the battery voltage is more than the solar panel, means it will become the high potential one. So it will provide the reverse voltage to the solar panel. In order to protect that, we place a diode, so which will act as a unidirectional current flow purpose. Means the diode will allow the current flow from the solar panel to the battery. It will block the current flow from the battery to the solar panel. So if there is no sunlight available, so in order to recharge the battery, we connected the TP4056 charging module. So which will take 5 volts input and provide as a 3.7 volts output to the battery. So when the battery is charging, there will be a light indication of red LED, and if the battery is fully charged, it will be off and the blue light will get switched on. So that is the indication of battery is fully charged. So it will take maximum 2 to 3 hours to be fully charged. After that, you can demonstrate by switching on this switch. Right, let us see the demonstration. So after switching on that, so it will go to the zero position. If I stop moving the lighting, then automatically the solar panel will stop rotation, because these two LDRs will get the same voltage to the Arduino Uno. Right, for every operation we can see one LED blinking on this Arduino Uno, which will show the status of the circuit is execution done in infinity loop. If it is not blinking, then we can restart the Arduino Uno by pressing this switch. This is a restart switch. It won't erase the program, just it will set the Arduino, reset the Arduino Uno.